Hall, with Bing Crosby and his distinguished guest for this Christmas Eve, Miss Faye Bader, star of the Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer picture Journey for Margaret, Jack Carson of Warner Brothers Pictures, Andrew Toombs of Paramount Pictures, and of course, Janet Blair, John Scott Trotter and his orchestra, the music Mason Howe, and the Charioteers. Makes the seventh Christmas that Bing has sung at Estee Fidelis here in the Old Craft Music Hall in Latin and English.
This seems like the most natural year for everybody to join in on the English program.
Might be nice if everyone at home joins us too.
Oh, we're counting on them.
Keeping your resolutions from New Year's to Christmas.
So I make mine on Christmas, and it's a cinch to keep them from New Year's. Well, how about you this evening, Janet?
Oh, sorry, Ken, but I'm busy.
Well, that's too bad. No, no, I mean later. Are you going to hang up your stockings so Santa can leave some toys?
Oh, not this year, Ken. This year, the girls are going to hang up their toys, hoping Santa Claus will leave stockings.
And it's with this Christmas thought for the distaff side of our listening membership that Janet Blair turns to a little thing called, with disarming simplicity, Steam is on the Beam.
Boss, can I get waiter now? Yeah, sure. I probably don't see anything you like. But if you do, I'm sure we won't have it.
Well, I want to buy a Christmas card that says, Merry Christmas to the one and only girl I have ever loved.
That we just happen to have.
Here you are, sir. Merry Christmas to the one and only girl I have ever loved.
Thanks. I'll take 2 dozen.
Steadfast little fellow, aren't you?
Say, who's that old guy over there running up and down the stairs?
Oh, that's that Santa Claus. He got his beard caught in the escalator.
From a thing like that, a guy can get a headache.
Yeah. Oh, how do you do, Mr. Carson? Well, I didn't expect to see you in this department. Last time I was here, you were in women's lingerie.
Yeah, I look so silly, though.
I moved over to woolen underwear.
Well, what are you laughing at?
It tickles.
Mr. Carson, I wonder if you could suggest a small gift for a small boy.
A small boy, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Say, do you know those tin soldiers in the toy department?
Why, yes.
That's funny, they don't know you.
Oh, is that so? Oh, funny thing. I'll write Washington about this. In fact, I think I'll write Adams and Jefferson, too.
You write to Washington and Jefferson, I'll deliver the letter myself.
To Washington and Jefferson?
Sure, I live in that corner.
Hiya, Mr. Carson. I'm Speed Crovany.
Speed? What isn't on your mind?
Well, I can't think of what I'm not thinking of.
Well, forget it. What don't you want?
How about that overcoat over there on that dummy?
That's no dummy. That's my brother.
Well, just how you feel. I got 4 of
them.
What's this funny-looking gadget here?
That's a combination toothbrush and pliers.
What do you do with a thing like that?
If you're too lazy to brush your teeth, pull them out.
Well, in that case, I'll take a 10-cent package of soap flakes, and I brought my birth certificate.
You don't need a birth certificate to buy soap.
Oh, so that's the one thing you don't need it for.
Look, this particular soap is great for washing your silk shirts.
Don't have any silk shirts.
What? No silk shirts?
Huh.
What do you do those long winter evenings when everybody else is rinsing out their fluffy things in lukewarm suds?
I get so lonesome.
Don't ever let it be said that I'm not the kind of a guy to take the shirt off his back. Here, take my shirt. $8. A beautiful shirt and no strings attached.
No strings? How am I going to hold my socks up?
Roll them down over your shoes. Make out like this fast.
You want me to come formal, huh?
Now, look. Here's what you do.
What's that do?
You take this silk shirt and you put it in the washing machine.
Ain't got no washing machine.
A wise guy, huh?
No washing machine.
Everybody's got a washing machine today. And you're going to stand and tell me you haven't got a washing machine? You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Well, in that case, I'll buy one.
You got a priority?
No, ma'am.
A wise guy, eh? Trying to buy a washing machine without a priority, eh? Trying to get me in trouble. You look like the criminal type with those fancy sideburns and that jute mill Balma can.
Well, gee, all I wanted to get was some soap flakes to wash my priority.
Well, okay. How many soap flakes would you want if I had them?
Will it be all right if I take 2 boxes?
A wise guy, eh?
Oh, gee, I'm sorry.
Try to hoard soap flakes. I'll report you. Let me tell you something, Bud. It's a good thing you came to my store. Anybody else would have reported you.
Well, I didn't mean no harm. Honest, I didn't. But I ain't leaving this store till I get something you've got.
Yeah? Do you know what I do to people who want what I've got when I ain't going to give what I got?
What you do?
I beat them to a pulp. I break their necks. Put my fingers in their eyes. Smash them. I practically annihilate them.
What happens to them?
I lose more customers that way.